thank you all for coming here this evening to help celebrate our 21st anniversary with us.
I wanted to test whether any of this co-creation actually made a difference in the long run. Does it actually, is it just an activity which makes you feel good, or does it result in a different product altogether? Does it result in something that is tangibly other than it would have been had it not taken place?
It's bigger than any of us could have done on our own. It's something that always exceeds, wildly exceeds the expectations of the participants. I never expected an entire community to be able to write an opera. But everyone has music in their heads, and given the right situation and the right structure, they can make a musical contribution to something which is also their own story.
I'm ahead of a primary school that Benoit and Prasad have designed. We get great joy every day when we go into the building, and it does work. They kept their language simple and straightforward so that it communicated the vision and the dream and the reality. And I think that's what you've got to do.
Of course, it's obvious, isn't it? If you involve kids very early on in the development of things which are going to affect their lives, and we all know that the buildings and the places and the environments that we create are going to affect their lives. If you involve them in that, so they're part of it.
We are no longer in a binary world where it's either this or that. Being both secure and accessible, private and public, and so on and so forth, is a much tougher thing to do with all these different interests.
How do you actually get the developer to say, yes, we'll spend money on this, because it has a social value?
Especially if you start to try and scale it up, what you come up against is vested interests, you come up against lack of funding, you come up against people being scared, and all of those things actually mean that an awful lot of what we've seen today cannot be anything other than local.
Some of the places that I showed, they look really bleak, but there's lots and lots of local value there about what people love. So it's about that kind of integration of social and cultural as well as the spatial. And it needs to also be about more than just the product, which is the building. It needs to be more about kind of civic society and all that network model.
The only way we're actually going to deal with our carbon economy is to actually have a complete cultural shift with a complete realignment of values. And it's very exciting times. I mean, everybody says that climate is a real downer, but actually the society that we could create could be totally wonderful.
First of all, to say there are dotted around the country examples of co-production of health in practice, but it's still in the margins. Why is it in the margins? Because the culture and tradition of the medical professions is very hard to shift. People are still not trained to think that, you know, the patient or the person they're treating or looking after knows as much as they do.
I mean, Einstein said, you know, you can't solve a problem with the same kind of thinking that created the problem.
And I think we've heard so many examples tonight of working with young people, because actually they just cut through the crap. And I think the reason we can't conceptualise the problem around climate change is because we don't want to. But I'm working with a whole generation of young people coming up who are happy to talk about those issues, who want to explore how they can make a difference, how they can change their world.
I'm optimistic. I think we are getting better at closing the gap between the need for people who want something and us who can help them get it through our language. And the more we do it, the less jargon we need use. The more we speak to children and young people, the less jargon we can use. But really, I think one of the most fantastic outcomes of increasing, growing co-creation is better language, better shared language.
I think it was lovely when Louis Kahn always says, you know what you want to build when you've built it. Yeah, because we've never got the finished building. We keep on going.
And finally, what Phil Blinston says about this is the most moving thing that I've ever personally heard a client say. He says that this building never lets us down, whatever we ask of it. And I think it's because it was actually made by them with us together, and everything was sort of thought through and considered in that kind of very strong collective spirit. Thank you.